As we try to ease the pressure the pandemic is putting on our healthcare system, a lot of us are staying home, but that means that some of us are ignoring those little health concerns that could become something bigger. Today on World Cancer Day, we want to check in with the CEO of the Canadian Cancer Society, Andrea Seale, to learn what you can do at home and when it's time to call the doctor. Andrea, welcome to the show. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. Good morning.
What are some of the most common signs of cancer and how can you check for them at home?
Well, yeah, we have, as you say, we have a concern that during the pandemic, people have been avoiding going to the doctor. You may have been ignoring some changes in your body. So the things to watch for are things like very rapid weight loss, blood in your urine or your stool, or maybe a new lump or growth. These are the kinds of things that could be an early sign of cancer and the kinds of things that you really shouldn't ignore. So go and see your doctor, have these things checked out.
Yeah, absolutely. Those look like red flags to me. If you're concerned about your health and you're at home, what can you do? I'm assuming there are, depending on what you're looking at on your body, there are different things that you can do and there's different resources out there for you.
Yeah, there's really, you know, it's not the kind of thing you can diagnose on your own. So you absolutely have to watch for those signs and then go and see your doctor. If you want to go check out our website, cancer.ca, or talk to our people on our helpline, they can help you understand the symptoms and help you navigate the healthcare system. But seeing your doctor is number one. And, you know, many doctors right now are doing virtual appointments. If you're worried about going to a doctor's office and being out in the public, many doctors are doing virtual appointments and phone calls as a first step.
Andrea, what if I'm worried about someone else, but I can't be with them because of the restrictions?
Yeah, this has been one of the most difficult things this year for people living with cancer is just that, you know, you don't have your same support system around you of family and friends who often are that circle of care for a person with cancer. So if you have someone in your life who's going through cancer, it's really important to reach out, to stay in touch, to listen to how they're doing, offer to help with, you know, the sort of daily tasks of life, of shopping, of cooking. And, you know, the cancer experience is very different for everyone. There's no way to predict how it would be for the person in your life, but being there to support them, to listen, that's number one.
And you were last on the show in April 2020, when we were still guessing at the impact this pandemic was going to have on cancer patients. Yeah. What do you know now that you were just taking a stab at back then?
Yeah, we do know that it's been an extremely difficult year. So, you know, with screening programs were paused for cancers like breast cancer and colon cancer screening programs, and we know that it's really important to find cancer early. So, people attending those appointments now and making sure that they're doing everything that they can to keep up with their health is very important. We also know that the delays in surgeries and treatments, many patients, almost half of patients have reported some kind of delay in their treatment. And this is really serious. That can have, you know, life and death consequences. So our big message on World Cancer Day is actually for everybody to do your part collectively to end the pandemic as quickly as possible, because this is what people with cancer need most, is to be able to have that reliable, timely access to our healthcare system.
We only have a few seconds left, but bearing in mind that there are already those backlogs for those who are diagnosed, what does that mean for people who think they might have cancer? What should they be expecting when they get a diagnosis and eventually treatment?
Yeah, well, you know, we're really fortunate to have an amazing healthcare system here. So the most important thing is to be seeing your doctor as quickly as possible so that you understand what your situation is and you can get the care that you need. And we want to know that you're not alone. If you have anxiety of coping with waits and delays, then that's what the Cancer Society is here for, is to help you cope. And you can reach out to us on our toll-free helpline or our chat on cancer.ca and speak to people who really understand what you're going through and can help you through it.
Andrea Seale, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really, really important information to pass on.
Thank you.
And if you have any concerns or know anyone living with cancer, you can call the Cancer Society, the Canadian Cancer Society's helpline at 888-939-3333.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this, be sure to subscribe here, or you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.